Hello students, in this video we are going to study about the another member of plant kingdom, that is Pteridophyta. Pteridophyta are also called as botanical snakes, and they are also referred as cryptogams because in Pteridophyta the reproduction is hidden and they do not bear seeds and flowers. In the earlier video I have already mentioned that Pteridophyta, Bryophyta and Thallophyta, all of them were grouped together in cryptogams because they do not bear seeds. Now few characteristics about Pteridophyta. Pteridophyta are the first terrestrial plants with differentiated vascular tissues. Vascular tissues means the plants which have the conducting tissues, that is xylem and phloem, for the transportation of minerals, water and food. Xylem is going to transport food, minerals and water from the roots, and then phloem is going to transfer the food or the minerals, water, to other parts of the plant or the branches and leaves. Pteridophyta includes fern. Now coming to habitat, Pteridophyta are mostly found in cool, damp and shady places, but there are some pteridophytes who prefer to live or found on sandy soil conditions. As we have seen in case of bryophytes, the main or the dominant phase in their life cycle was gametophyte, but in case of pteridophytes the main or the dominant phase of their life cycle is sporophyte, where because of the differentiation or well differentiated vascular tissues, they are divided into true roots, stem and leaves. Now coming to the leaves of pteridophytes. Pteridophytes, if in pteridophytes the leaves are small, then they are called as microphylls, for example in case of Selaginella, and if the leaves are large, then those leaves are called as macrophylls, for example in case of ferns. Now coming to the life cycle, as we know that dominant phase of the life cycle in the life cycle of pteridophyte is sporophyte. These sporophytes bear sporangia that are subtended on these leaf-like appendages called sporophylls. There are some cases in which the sporophyll form distinct compact structures called strobili or cones. For example, in case of Selaginella and Equistem, there is the presence of this compact structure, that is strobili. Now coming to the life cycle, as we have already mentioned that the dominant phase in the life cycle of Pteridophyta is the sporophyte. Now the sporangia, on meiosis, produces spores in the spore mother cell. It is the spores that germinate to give conspicuous small multicellular and free living photosynthetic thalloid gametes called prothallus. Now the question arises, what all are the requirements and why the pteridophytes are very limited in number? Since pteridophytes require special or the restricted requirements are there, and for the reproduction process it requires water, that is why the spread of living pteridophyte is very limited and they're only restricted to narrow geographical areas. Now moving further, the gametophytes bear male sex organs called antheridia and female sex organs called archegonia. As we know that antheridia produces antherozoids and water is required for their transfer. So, in the presence of water, antheridia releases antherozoids which are transferred to the archegonium or at the tip of archegonium where the fusion of gametes takes place. And results in the formation of zygote, that is diploid in nature. Then this zygote produces a multicellular or well-differentiated sporophyte on reduction division, which is the dominant phase of pteridophyte, and these pteridophytes then result into the formation of spores. The spores that are formed in pteridophytes are of two types. One is homosporous and another is heterosporous. The plants which produces similar kind of spores are called as homosporous plants. For example, in case of majority of pteridophytes produces homospores, whereas the plants who produces that produces different kind of spores, they are called heterosporous plants. The difference in the spores is the size. If the plant produces large spores, then it is called megaspore and it will lead to the formation of female gametophyte. And if it produces another spore that is formed is small, and it is called microspores, which results in the formation of male gametophyte. Now, the female gametophyte are retained on the parent sporophyte. The female gametophyte in these plants are retained here for variable periods, and the development of spores into embryo takes place within the female gametophyte. For example, heterosporous plants are Selaginella in this case and Salvinia. These two plants produces heterospores. During this event, there is a important step in evolution, that is the seed habit it forms. Next, we will be going to study about gymnosperms. Thank you.